Hi everyone, I'm Jovana Genisevic from Atlassian, and welcome back to our series on how to create a developer experience platform using Compass. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create scorecards in Compass.
So far in our video series, we have shown what a developer experience platform is and the features you can expect from a populated platform, how to create a new instance of Compass and populate the software catalog using GitHub, how to onboard your engineering organization by assigning components to owners. In this video, I'll be showing you how to create scorecards in Compass. In Compass, you can create custom scorecards to measure the health of your components based on your unique requirements. Creating your own scorecards enables you to define company-wide standards and policies to ensure that all teams are aiming for the same standards. For example, you could create a security scorecard that tracks the number of vulnerabilities per software component. It also enables you to define team-level standards to ensure they follow their own best practices, in addition to the company-wide standards.
Now let's get into creating a custom scorecard. From the top navigation, select Health. At the top right corner, click the gray button to create scorecards. Enter the scorecard's name and description. For this purpose, we're writing risk management scorecard and we're putting in some description. To select the owner of the scorecard, start typing the name and select the user from the drop-down list. For the purposes, I'm just going to show you that you can search for a particular owner, but for this scenario, I'm going to use myself. An owner is someone who is an expert in the subject area and can be the point of contact. Adding an owner is optional, but we do recommend you add one. Next, you can choose to apply the scorecard manually or automatically. Applying it manually means that after creating the scorecard, you have to go and individually select all the components you would like the scorecard applied to. If you select to apply automatically, you need to select at least one component type, which will then make this scorecard available for the components of this particular type you choose. You can be even more specific in how you want your scorecard applied. By adding more filters, you specify whether you want the scorecard applied by component label, a component tier level, or a component team. And in that case, look for a corresponding value in the dropdown that appears. When you are all set, click Next. After that, you need to set up criteria. You have to have at least one criterion. Select a criterion from the list and enter a percentage that reflects its importance. The sum of the percentages for all criteria must be 100%. In this case, I'm choosing a field for on-call and any link that is added will apply, and making my weight to 100%. Select Add Criterion to keep adding more. And finally, select Create. This will then create your scorecard with all the behavior you previously selected. Let's recap what we've covered in this video. We've seen how we can create custom scorecards. They can be applied manually, or they can be applied automatically. If automatically, then one component type is required. We can add more filters to make our scorecard more specific by adding a component label, a component tier level, or a component team. We need to add at least one criteria, and the sum of the percentages for all criteria must be 100%. Thanks for watching.